north of downtown L.A., we're live from beautiful Dodger Stadium. Today, a matchup out of the National League West between the San Francisco Giants and the Los Angeles Dodgers. Alongside Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac, and guys, the Dodgers played well in the series so far, winning the first two in this three-game set.
Yeah, and to sweep this team right here would be a huge momentum boost. It is not easy to sweep a series. I don't care if it's three games or four games. I think back to Bobby Cox. His big thing was you just want to win series. Two out of three, three out of four. But when you have a chance to sweep a team, you have to take advantage of it.
David Price, a southpaw from Tennessee, is the man on the mound. Dan, any thoughts?
Hey, Matt, this guy keeps his team in the ballgame. He's won two of his last three starts, so he's been throwing the ball really well. And one of the keys for this guy is getting early outs to keep his pitch count down. If he can do that, he should be able to get into the seventh or eighth inning in this one here today.
And it's fouled away.
First pitch, 106.
Hit hard down the right field line. But this will be a foul ball as he's behind 0-2 now. Nothing in two count and the pitch. Way outside. 1-2. Liner towards second. And there's one away. And here's how the visiting San Francisco Giants line up in this one. Mark DeRosa, what's the key in avoiding the sweep?
Matty, you focus on this lineup. The middle of the order jumps out at you because of the big power. But my focus today is on the table setters, the guys that set the tone. They have to be willing to work the count and find ways to get on base and create a little bit of havoc on the defense.
And this one's nowhere close as that bounces to the plate for ball one. Dero, Danny, this L.A. Dodger ball club as they enter play here this afternoon. They've had it going the last 10 games. They're 7-3 over that stretch, including a win last time out.
Yeah, Matty. Dan, this team is playing well. They're getting closer in the division race. I guess my question to you, I want to ask you, did you find that you started to really pitch better as the summer months started to get hotter?
No doubt about it. Not only does the team start feeling better, but I think you get a good vibe starting to go throughout the clubhouse. You realize that the schedule is starting to wind itself down. Every game is more important. The bigger the game, hopefully.
And he'll lay out to make a spectacular catch. Wow. Mike Yastrzemski digging in at the plate. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. The average to start play at 315. 21 homers and 54 runs batted in. And the fastball hitting 93 on the gun. It's 1-1. Just underway here in Southern California. Into the corner and slicing foul. That misses, and we're even at 2-2. Now Price misses here on 2-2, and he runs it full, 3 balls and 2 strikes. Grounded to the right, fielded cleanly. Throw on to Muncy, gets him, and with that they'll end the inning. So a relatively routine start for the top of the first here. It's the Giants nothing, Dodgers coming up. You're watching NL West Baseball, and it's on The Show. Caleb Berriger, a Michigan-born lefty, gets the starting job here. What do we need to know here, Danny?
Hey, it's hard to have all four of your pitches on, but I think if this guy can have two or three of his four pitches and have command of them, he's going to have a really good game.
So that'll bring in Mookie Betts. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
Leading off, Gilbert Dodgers. The right fielder, Mookie Betts.
Now here's the pitch.
Oh.
Danny, D-Row, this Giants team as they begin play here this afternoon. They were losers last time out, but still in a decent groove as they'd won four of five prior to that.
Yeah, guys, dropping yesterday was a heartbreaker without question. But you know what? You find a way. You show up to the yard today, you get out of the cab, and you watch countless hours of video, and you try and formulate a game plan to get this back to 500. 1-1 to start the road trip, and you're moving in the right direction.
Now here it comes.
Hey!
He obviously found a great feel for that breaking ball while warming up before the game. Leadoff hitter getting two curveballs is usually not the norm.
The 1-2. Look out. That one almost got away from him. 2-2 now.
You know, we'll see him work both sides of the plate with his curveball. Maybe not that far in, but he'll move that pitch around the zone to give it a different look.
And a slider gets away from him here as it just about got him in the ankle. And he fouls this one off. Payoff pitch one more time. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Dickerson's under it. And he hauls it in for the first out of the inning. Now a moment for the Los Angeles Dodgers starting lineup. Who do you have your eye on, Dan?
Oh, man, I love what A.J. Pollock does for this offense. The guy is in the middle of the lineup, and when he's in the middle, things just happen. Guys in front of him get on, he drives them in, and if not, he has the ability to get things started and set the guys up behind him. He's a force.
Standing in now, Justin Turner, as he'll take a look at ball one. He'll enter play here with an average just over 250. 14 homers and 38 runs batted in. The windup and the 1-0 pitch. Turner is just shy of 6 feet at 5'11", a right-handed batter and thrower. He's a veteran of 13 years at the major league level, which really points to the consistency he's shown since he first broke in.
Yeah, Matty, you ain't kidding right there. 10 years, we refer to that in the biz as hitting full pension.
And the throw is a high one, but he's able to keep a foot tethered on the bag, and that becomes out number two.
Seager.
Here's Corey Seager. He had a couple of hits in yesterday's contest. Outfield shaded toward right center. Here's the first pitch. And he swings through a fastball and doesn't catch up with it. It's 0-1.
Hey, when you're featuring a mid-90s fastball like this pitcher, attack with that pitch. Get ahead. Get the offense on their toes. That opens up the off-speed pitches later in the game.
Behind 0-2 now. Now here's the pitch.
If I'm in the box, you take a step out right here. Take a deep breath after that high fastball. You got to be leery of him burying something in the dirt.
Good job going down and hanging with it that time. Bases are empty here with two men out. got caught lunging there as this one's fouled away. And this one runs in on him as he can't get his arms extended. A great pitch there, and the inning is over. Dodgers down in order, and this is still a nothing-nothing ballgame. Now it'll be Alex Dickerson. He'll get us started in the top of the second.
Alex.
Here's the first pitch. Good fastball down around the knees there, taken for a strike. Today's contest is, of course, the finale of the series, and the Dodgers have really dominated so far. They've got the chance to complete a sweep with a win in this one.
This team going for the sweep is looking for some home cooking. It's always nice to win a series, but particularly nice when you can sweep a series at home.
And set up behind the dish is Clyde Washington, as you see the rest of our umpiring crew there.
You know, D-Row, he is a pitcher's best friend, Clyde Washington. Down in the strike zone, he'll definitely call that ball right at the knees.
If he's consistent with it, Dan, which Clyde always is, I'm okay with it.
Ready to deal. Here's the 2-1. Fouled off.
Hey, last two pitches back-to-back. Off speed, then he's late on the fastball. He could pretty much do anything he wants right here on the mound.
Count remains 2-2. And they were able to put up double digits in the runs column yesterday, so a similar performance from the lineup would give them a good chance at least at a series sweep.
Listen, it's hard in this day and age with all the quality pitching to put up double-digit runs like they did yesterday. They'd certainly like to have some of those back if they could and add them to today's box score.
Swung on and driven to right, and no doubt about it. Gone to lead off the inning. A solo shot here to straightaway right field, number 14 on the season, as the Giants are staked to a 1-0 lead. Certainly a tape measure shot there as we take a look at it with our show track technology. 111 miles an hour was the exit velocity, so it comes as no surprise that it carried as far as it did. In now, Wilmer Flores. He swings and hits it foul off to the right and out of play. He appeared as a pinch hitter in yesterday's contest. Here's the 0-1 pitch. Went after the high one there. A swing and a miss.
It's not easy to get your barrel to a pitch that high. That can be an effective location as long as he keeps it above the letters.
And here's a fastball on 0-2, but it misses. 1-2 now.
Stone cold take right there. That fastball very well could have sent him packing back to the bench.
And that one misses badly. It's ball two.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
Sent on the ground out to second. It's flagged down deep in the hole. Throw in time at first. A nice play in short right for the first out.
Hey, let's take a look at the Dodgers on defense. And let's focus on Corey Seager. Cal Ripken Jr., anyone? This guy looks like the spitting image of Iron Man. I think he's just scratching the surface of a Hall of Fame career. Multiple MVPs, gold gloves, you name it. Corey Seager is on fire.
To the plate now, Kurt Casale. As he'll take a look at a high strike here on the outside corner, it's 0-1. The average not quite where he wants it, down in the 220s. 8 home runs and 29 driven in. Price ready with the 0-1. swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone.
Yeah, as they say, there's a hole in his swing in that location, so a good job there of exploiting that. That can be real hard for some guys to overcome when teams start figuring out what locations you just can't handle.
In is the third baseman, Evan Longoria. As he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one. Comes into play here at 273. Six home runs and an even 20 RBIs. Favorable call in there for a strike.
Hey, I got to commend him a little bit. Lead off homer, and now he's one pitch away from getting out of this inning without any further damage.
The Giants have struck first here. They lead it 1-0 as we play the second. Swing and a miss. Blew the fastball right by him, and the inning is over. When the Giants come to town, it's bye-bye, baby. On to the bottom of inning number two. It's 1-0 San Francisco. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and that'll bring forward Cody Bellinger.
The center field, Cody Bellinger.
Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. Berriger utilizes a good curveball as a part of his arsenal, but it's not just your run-of-the-mill breaking ball. It's unique in that he's able to throw it with great velocity, a power curve, if you will. The 1-0 home. Here is a ground ball now for the shortstop to the right of second, and that's the first out.
Batting fifth.
Okay, here's how San Francisco lines up defensively. And this team, they're not going to be moving around as much as some of the new age teams. The shifting and moving the third baseman over second base and the right fielder to play third base. This is going to be your stationary team, trusting pitchers to execute pitches.
So now to the plate, A.J. Pollock, as he will look at a first pitch fastball for ball one. And he misses again, 2-0. In there, 2-1.
He's gotten a favorable call or two at the plate in this at bat, so that take on 2-0 is probably a result of feeling like the umpire's got a pretty tight zone. Didn't go his way that time, though.
Belted high and deep into right center. Going back is the center fielder. Goodbye, home run. Solo shot to right center, number 13 for him on the year, and the Dodgers are back even now at one apiece.
That's the price you pay right there when you try and sneak a fastball past this guy. Power hitter, and every power hitter in the league knows you got to start with the numero uno, number one, man. You got to get on the heater and adjust to everything else, and he did just that.
Next up is Max Muncy. Fouled away. That batting average hovering in the high 230s. 14 homers and 32 driven in. One and one to the Dodgers' first baseman.
One ball, one strike.
Too high there, and maybe a bit outside as well. 2-1.
Hey, that's a nice take by the batter right there, but that's a non-competitive off-speed pitch. Got to do better to at least entice a swing.
3-1.
I'd be real surprised if he goes back out away there on the mound. This is a count for a fastball challenge, and we'll see if he's ready for it in the box.
Bases are empty, one man out. Down the right field line. Around first, digging for two. And he is in at second base with a one-out double.
Nice execution right there. Ball was down below the knees. He stayed through it and was able to drive it for a base hit.
Here now is Will Smith, swinging a ball hit on the ground, and there are two away now.
Well executed two-seamer on the outside corner that time, and that's what you'll get a lot of with that pitch. He rolled right over it.
Batter will be Gavin Lux as he pops the first pitch foul behind the plate. He comes in at 262 on the year, four home runs and 14 driven in. Come set, the 0-1. Now a fastball here, not close, and it's 1-1 now. Muncy on third with two out. Swing and a miss on the pitch outside. 1-2 now.
That's a really nice thing about pitching with the base open. You can work out of the strike zone a little bit more and try to get a guy to chase your pitch just like that one.
Ready with the 1-2. A fastball well off the plate inside.
34 pitches for him through an inning and two-thirds right now. That's not terrible, but it's a lot higher than he'd like.
Two outs here with a runner at third. A swing and a ground ball to third. And the off-balance throw gets him as he takes away a hit and the side is retired. One for the Dodgers on the solo home run. We play two, all even at one apiece. Back alongside Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac, Matt Vasgersian, as it'll be Brandon Belt getting ready to lead things off here. First offering on its way.
Oh. One ball, no strike.
The 1-0. Doesn't catch the outside corner, it's a ball.
It's a lot easier to hit when you're putting yourself in good hitters' counts. This guy's done a great job not swinging at pitchers' pitches. And when he's getting the ball in his zone, he's getting the barrel to it. He's been hot lately.
2-1 after the foul ball there. And it's fouled away. Two two coming now from Price.
No,
full count. 3-2.
Three ball.
You can bet they'd love ball four here. That gives the pitcher on deck an obvious bunt situation to move the runner into scoring position.
3-2 pitch. And he lays off there. Ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin inning number three.
Yeah, and as a starter, the last thing you want to do is let a team answer when your guys just scored a run for you. So he's thinking ground ball right here to try to get a double play and end this threat.
Digging in will be Caleb Berriger. Now the first pitch. And they indeed have the pitcher bunting here as he gets this one down. There's one back to first, but he wasn't able to set his feet that time as he gets knocked down and they only get one.
He got the bunt down, but he didn't deaden it enough. Really good job by the first baseman to charge in and make a good throw to second to get the lead runner.
At the plate, Donovan Solano. Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. And they'll have runners at second and third following the one-out double.
Everyone knows that this guy's numbers are not where he wants them to be so far this year, but you never know by that swing. He looked fluid and confident driving that pitch for a double. We'll see if that gets him going a bit.
So that brings up the outfielder Austin Slater as he'll take a look at an off-speed pitch here that misses for ball one. 0 for 1 here in the early going. That evens it up 1 and 1. Second and third here, one man out. In there, 1-2 now. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. Tough pitch to lay off there, but he did, and it's even up at 2-2. And it's a full count, 3-2 to Austin Slater.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Runners are at second and third with one down. High in the air out to center field. Bellinger's under it. And the play is made, but this should be good enough for an RBI as the runner from third tags up. And the run is in to score as they'll grab the lead here, 2-1. So a runner in scoring position with two men gone. And now stepping in is Mike Yastrzemski. First pitch on its way. This one's outside, quite a bit off the plate that time. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. Popped him up. Smith is there, and that will end the inning. Giants will have to be content with just the one. We'll head now to the home half of inning number three. San Francisco leads this one 2-1. Leading off the inning, it'll be David Price, and they could use a spark from him here.
No pitcher.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one. Edge of the zone that time, taken and ruled a strike. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Strike three on a pitch in the dirt. And he makes the throw to first. Price is retired, and there's one away. Here's Mookie Betts. Flied out in his first at-bat, so make him 0-1 so far. Now the pitch. Short, hit hard. And he'll reach first as they can't make the play on him.
Jeez, this looked like a routine grounder that just got away from him. Every school kid knows that you've got to look it all the way into the glove. He didn't, and now they've got to deal with a one-out base runner.
Stepping in now, Justin Turner has so weighed out a breaking pitch here that finds the zone for strike one. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. Oh, and you talk about a pitcher getting the benefit of the doubt. That's low, but called a strike anyway. Nothing in two now. Working for the punch out and the offering. And this one's in the dirt. And he'll rein it in as the count moves to 1-2. Has a look, now the pitch.
Nope, that's off the plate.
I know he buried that slider in right there, but that's a dangerous pitch. If he doesn't pot commit and bury that inside, it leaks out over the plate. He can get hurt with that pitch.
The 2-2. Now this is hit not all that hard out to second. The second for one. Relay to belt. They get two, and that'll end the inning. Like clockwork, a 4-6-3 double play to end the threat. More ahead from Dodger Stadium right after this. Welcome back to Dodger Stadium. Let's send it down to the field and Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. Between innings, I was able to discuss the current state of the Giants lineup with their manager, Gabe Kapler. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. It's still pretty early in the game, but they've seen a lot of pitches already. And he thinks the two runs they've pushed across so far is just the beginning, given the quality of the at-bats they're putting together.
All right. Thanks, Heidi. All set for the start of the fourth. And into bat next, it'll be Alex Dickerson.
And going back to that previous at bat when he hit the two-strike breaking ball for a home run, something tells me that this guy, when he gets behind in the count, sits on something off-speed or the breaking ball.
On the move is Betts. Around first, he's digging for second. And now this will get over the wall down the line out there for a ground rule double.
When you play in this park where the fences are shorter, this is going to happen more often than any other ballparks.
Standing in now, Wilmer Flores. As he'll take a look at a pitch too low, it's ball one. Runner in scoring position here already following the ground rule double. Hard ground ball to third. Oh, and he can't come up with it. And they still managed to get an out on the play. Some nice teamwork and heads-up baseball there.
The catcher, number two, perfect, salad.
At the plate now, Kurt Casale, high and deep to right center. Calling for it is Betts, and Mookie's got it for the second out. That was a tough play, so let's take another look at it with Showtrack. Seemed to get a solid read off the bat, took a good angle at it, and he covered over 100 feet to make the grab. And I'm sure he'll be getting some high fives for that one. In now, Evan Longoria. Popped him up. Seager is there for it. And that retires the side. Giants lead one. They lead it 2-1. Just about set to go for the last of the fourth. But before we do that, here's Heidi Watney.
Matt, during the break, I caught up with Dave Roberts, the Dodgers skipper, about his lineup's performance so far, and flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. Yes, they've only scored one run, but he said they've done a great job of forcing the pitch count up, and he thinks that's going to lead to more offense for them as this game goes on.
All right, Heidi, thank you. Bottom of the inning now, and coming forward now is the shortstop, Corey Seager.
Not shortstop.
He's ready. Here's the first pitch. Can't find the zone there as he lays off the breaking ball. And he fouls this one off. Fouled off again, and now he's in a 1-2 hole.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
Two balls and two strikes to Corey Seager. Fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning. So here's Cody Bellinger.
Cody Bellinger.
First offering on its way. A ball and no strikes. Fourth inning of a 2-1 ball game. And he gets a piece of this one to foul it toward the backstop. A 1-1 count. Here's the pitch. Maybe too much break on the slider. 2-1. Can't find the zone there, and it's 3-1.
Hey, he's had great command all day. Want to see how aggressive he is in the zone with a three-ball count.
One out, nobody on. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact.
3-2 counts are usually a time to challenge the hitter, but I think he'll be careful here. Shoot for the corner, and if you miss and you walk him, so what? That's better than him putting one in the seats.
No walks yet. Here's the delivery. Bat explodes as this has popped up. And he'll find a way to dodge the shrapnel out there to make the play for out number two.
Now back.
So two out, nobody on. And that'll bring up A.J. Pollock.
Well, Matty, we know he's got the timing on the fastball locked in. That's what he got a hold of on that home run in the previous at bat. You do not come off the heater. Have to be leery of the off speed. But stay on the fastball. He's got to throw it again.
And that'll miss up an in ball two.
I wonder if that homer rattled him a little bit. He's certainly a little bit more cautious against him this time around.
Nope. 3-0.
No surprise here that they're working around this big boy. Certainly not going to let this guy tie the game up with something fat out over the heart of the plate.
One run, two hits. No errors for the Dodgers thus far. Pollock in front, three balls and a strike.
You can really tell they're trying to keep the ball in on this big slugger right here.
Is that an effort to keep him from getting extended, do you think?
Yeah, I think that's the idea, Matt. But he might spin to win if he starts looking for it in there.
And this pitch is taken here for ball four. So the Dodgers able to extend the inning here with two away.
Well, he loses him there, but that's just the first walk he's given up, along with a couple of hits, so his command has been pretty solid so far.
Two down with a runner at first, and that'll bring up the left-handed hitter, Max Muncy.
From the stretch, here's the pitch.
Hey, he's got great feel for that pitch right there. He can throw it anytime he wants for a strike.
Pollock, the runner at first with two gone. Throw over to the bag, and a dive, but he's back in. In there, and he's in control 0-2 now.
Boy, you can see he's coming right at this guy, just pounding the ball in the strike zone. He certainly has the advantage now. This guy hasn't even swung the bat yet.
A little too much bite on the breaking ball that time, as it's well off the outside. Runners off for second. Fouled off. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Hit down the third baseline. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. As a look, now the pitch. Swing and a miss, and that's out number three. One left for LA. They're down 2-1. You ain't from where you say you're from. You ain't done what you say you're done. We don't believe that. So now to the plate, Brandon Belt drew a base on balls his first time up.
Number nine, Brandon Belt.
Now the pitch. Too high that time with the inning's first pitch. It's ball one.
That hook stayed up in the zone. You can see he struggled with that curveball early. He's trying to find that release point with his off-speed pitches. We'll have to see if he can find the feel for that thing moving forward.
Now the 1-0. Finds the zone, strike one. The 1-1 home. Takes a pass and misses. That's strike two. Maybe trying to back him up a bit there with the fastball. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first down.
Up next to the Giants.
Stepping in next, Caleb Berriger. He's 0-for-1 thus far. First pitch on the way. Reaches out, but he can't get it. It's nothing and one. Gets the fastball by him here, and he's in control 0-2.
His command has been outstanding so far, hitting nearly all of his spots, and that's been a big factor why he's been so successful up to this point.
Now the 0-2 from Price. Lofted in the air out toward right center. And this is handled easily, so quickly two are gone here to start the fifth.
The batter, number seven, second base. Solano.
So the batting order turns over now and set to go Donovan Solano. A hit and two at-bats for him at this point in the ballgame. First pitch of the AB on its way.
That's the ball. 1-0.
The windup and the 1-0 pitch. Now this is swung on, and here's another fly ball out to right field. And no trouble for him as he makes the catch to end the inning. Giants down in order as they're unable to add to their 2-1 lead. Set now for the bottom of the fifth, and that brings up Will Smith.
The catcher.
Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch. Fouled away. And this catches the inside corner. Good spot there. It's 0-2. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. And the pitch. They really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out.
Well, this has been a completely different performance from the offense that we saw yesterday. They were looking like the 27 Yankees 24 hours ago, but they've been held in check so far in this one. That's kind of how baseball goes, though.
Into the box now, Gavin Lux. Just able to get a piece of that for strike one. He's 0-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. And the pitch. Fifth inning, 2-1 our score. It's 1-2.
Basic pitching right there. 0-2 fastball up and out of the zone. Change the eye level. Now time to go to that curveball down and away.
Now a swinging bunt. There's ball two as the slider dips below the zone. Here now the 2-2. Is swung on and missed, strike three.
Two up, two down on strikes in this inning. He looks really sharp out there, guys.
The pitcher, David Wright.
To the plate now, David Price. As he lays off a fastball too low for ball one. He'll attempt to put the ball in play for a change here with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning. The 1-0 home is looked at for the first strike. Two out, nobody on. Looked like the fastball got away from him there. It's ball two.
You certainly know he's not trying to work around the pitcher. But sometimes the hardest thing to do is to throw a strike to a guy that you know won't swing the bat.
Now the 2-1. Is a fastball taken high for a ball.
Well, he really needs to make this guy swing the bat right here. He's not the type of hitter you want to dance around with.
3-1.
Hey, I still believe in my heart the best pitch is a well-executed fastball down and away, and that's exactly what that is. He swings at that. That's off the end of the bat. That's not hard contact at all, and that's an easy out for the defense.
And he misses here, ball four. And somehow he manages to walk his opposite number. Wow.
Looked like he might have gotten squeezed a little bit right there, and you know he's talking to himself in his head about it. That kind of stuff goes both ways, though. Hitters get their fair share of crummy calls going against them, too.
Into the box, Mookie Betts. As he'll take a look at ball one. 0-2 from him so far in this one. The 1-0 home. It's a fastball that misses.
Now this is the kind of count this guy feeds on at the plate. You can bet he's geared to hit the fastball right here.
Here it comes, 2-0.
That fastball really got away from him there. That's kind of a red flag for me that he's starting to tire or wear down a little bit. The first thing that goes is location, and then your mechanics.
We'll see if this continues.
A 3-0. And he misses again. Ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on balls.
Man, when you don't get a call on a pitch that good, you have to wonder if maybe it's personal. You can't blame him for being angry, but he's got to find a way to move on and focus on the next batter.
So stepping in is Justin Turner, trying here to plate the tying run from second. Trying to hold the lead, here's the delivery.
After the walk and with runners on the bags, he couldn't afford to fall behind here. Nice job of jumping ahead with strike one.
Price at second, Betts at first, two out in the inning. Fly ball right down the line and left. Dickerson's on the move. He's there to make the play, and that'll retire the side. Couple of walks in the inning, but nothing on the scoreboard. We'll come right back with more from Dodger Stadium in just a moment. Top half of the sixth about to get started, and standing in the outfielder, Austin Slater. Now the first pitch here from Price. The 1-0 home.
Two balls, no strike.
A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Shallow center. Bellinger's in pursuit. He's there and records the first down.
The right fielder, number five, Mike Yastrzemski.
And now here is Mike Yastrzemski. Third at bat in this one. He's bounced out and popped out in his two previous trips. And that misses ball one. And he falls behind now, 2-0.
That was a tempting pitch to swing at right there. A big power guy like this really wants something that he can elevate and drive out of the ballpark.
Price comes home to 2-0. 3-0 now.
I wouldn't be surprised if he had the green light here. Matter of fact, I know he's got the green light here. He's looking for something set or cut, and he's looking to do damage.
And he'll just float a change in here now for a strike. Ripped down the first baseline, and he'll take it to the bag himself for the out.
Up next to the Giants, the left fielder, Alex Dickerson.
Alex Dickerson will stride in one more time as we flash you back to earlier. This was a big blow right here as he leaves the yard with plenty to spare. Now the first pitch.
He's in complete command of his two-seamer right now. It's got great movement, great depth, running all over the place. This offense is going to have a tough time.
Price into his motion. Here's the 0-1.
If you're going to have success against some of the better hitters in the game, you got to get that pitch right there. 0-2, he's almost certainly out. 1-1, he's got a chance to really do some damage.
And the pitch. And it's fouled away. And that last pitch from Price was number 73 in the ballgame. And that one misses badly. It's ball two.
Two balls, two strikes.
Seared down the first baseline. And a sliding attempt at first, but this sneaks by him, a base hit.
Dan, with that single, he's now three quarters of the way to hitting for the cycle. Toughest one still on the shelf, though. He's got to get a triple.
Yeah, that's your set at D-Row. That's one of those that's either got to hit right down the line or one of those tweeners in the gap. He has enough speed, so if he can find a gap or find one down the line, maybe he can do it, and he's going to at least get one more at bat in this one.
So now to the plate, Wilmer Flores, as the changeup to him drops in there for the first strike. Low scoring game thus far, 2-1 here in the sixth. Counts even at 1-1 to Wilmer Flores. Slow roller, left side. He's got it. Throw on to Muncy, gets him, and with that, they'll end the inning. One left for San Francisco. They still lead it 2-1. Johnny Cueto enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth.
Now pitching for San Francisco, number 47, Johnny.
Next at the plate will be Corey Seager. Career head-to-head meetings with Johnny Cueto, batting at an even 400. Also of note, the four home runs he's hit against him.
Seager!
Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch.
This is why the manager pencils these guys in the middle of the order. Big spot, time for them to get back in this game with a couple quality ABs.
That's in there, and he's deep in the hole now, 0-2. Now some action out in the Giants' bullpen as they'll have both a left-hander and a right-hander get loose. The windup and the 0-2 pitch. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. And the slider is low and inside as he just about got him there. The 1-2 offering looked like a slider that time, but it's 2-2.
One thing's clear, he's not afraid to pitch inside, right? One pitch ducks him away, then he comes right back with another one. So clearly this pitcher, he's not afraid to work that inner half of the plate.
And now a pitch on the way. He struck him out, the third time he's fanned in the game.
Oh, man, he's been absolutely getting overmatched at the plate the last couple of games. That's his fifth strikeout in this series alone. So clearly this pitching staff, they figured out how to attack this guy. We'll see if he can make any adjustments.
Cody Bellinger at the plate now. And Cueto starts him out with strike one. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. Oh, and this at-bat is quickly moving from bad to worse. It's 0-2 now.
Hey, I can't have one of my best left-handed power bats fishing for balls off the plate.
And it's another K. So back-to-back strikeout victims to start this relief outing.
No problems for him on the mound since he's come out of the pen to start this inning. That's back-to-back K's, and he's making it look pretty easy. This has the makings of a good outing so far.
Next to hit, A.J. Pollock. He hits with two away as they continue to trail in this close game.
Well, Matt, this has been a big inning on the mound. He's had to face the middle of the order, and so far he's held them at bay.
Yeah, this feels like the kind of inning we'll look back on at the end of the game, even if the result of it changes dramatically here. First pitch on its way. In there, no balls and a strike.
No ball. One strike.
Put that in the memory bank. First time he breaks out a curveball right there, and it's a pretty good one.
Little chopper back to the mound. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Dodgers. Our score remains 2-1. Tony Gonsolin is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number 7.
Number 26.
Seventh inning ready to roll, and next to hit is the catcher, Kurt Casale. Ready to deliver, here comes the first pitch. Curveball looked at here for strike one. Gonsolin, a California-born ball player, he was a ninth-round pick back in the 2016 first-year player draft.
Hey, this guy's got a chance to be an absolute steal. Being drafted where he was, there are definite signs that he has a chance to make an impact at the big league level.
Behind 0-2 now. And he takes strike three called on the fastball, one gone.
Nice job there taking care of the leadoff hitter via the strikeout. I'll tell you, in a one-run game, especially this late, getting that first guy in the inning is so important. It changes the whole complexion of the inning, so that was a big out.
At the plate now, Evan Longoria, as he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls and a strike. 0-2 for him to this point. This is popped up. Muncy is under it. He's got it, and there are two down now.
The first baseman, number 9, Brandon Bell.
Here's the first baseman, Brandon Bell. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch. Look for him to try and stay back a little bit more. Let the ball get a little deeper. Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to rush a heater right here.
You know, because this is just a one-run game, this doesn't strike me as a situation where he's going to be working around a guy. I think he's going to challenge him right here.
And they'll run this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now.
Not much you can do with that one. Tied him up in knots.
Pitch taken. Several inches below the zone, in fact. And he fouls this one off. Another 2-2 offering.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
Fouled off. We're in the seventh inning now of a pitcher's duel. 2-1 our score. And that one yanked just foul. And he'll get to see another one. It'll be the 10th pitch of this at-bat. The next 3-2. Popped up. Turner has a play. And the inning is over. Giants are down 1-2-3. They lead it 2-1. Now the skipper's on his way out toward the home plate area, and I believe that means we're going to have a double switch here. Harleen Garcia will come on now, and he'll slide into the seventh spot in the lineup following the double switch. Brandon Crawford is into the ballgame as well, as he'll slide into the pitcher's spot, hitting ninth now on the double switch. Now to bat, Max Muncy. His prior history versus this arm, not a big sample size, 0-1.
Muncy.
First pitch on the way, and he'll power in a fastball that time at 94 for strike one. Sets the target low here, and it misses 1-1. Now here it comes. Fouled away. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball. Fastball is outside. It's full now, 3-2. And the payoff pitch struck him out.
Well, we've seen some really good pitching from these guys in this one. The bullpen has looked sharp and backed up a nice effort turned in by the starter. These days, pitching has become a full staff effort, and I've been impressed with the job these guys have done so far.
Stepping in now, Will Smith. As the first pitch to him is a changeup that can't find the zone. It's ball one. No hits to this point. Home is laid off for ball two.
Pretty easy takes to start out this at bat. None of those pitches were even close to the strike zone.
Hard hit ball to second. He's right there. And there's out number two.
Up next to the second baseman.
Into the box, Gavin Lux. He went down on strikes last time up. Here's the first pitch to him. Up. 0-1, here it comes. And low, it's a ball and a strike. Bases are empty here with two men out. And it's fouled away. Here comes the 1-2. Grounded to first. Belt will take this one himself, and that ends the inning. Dodgers down in order. They still trail it here, 2-1. Stepping in, Brandon Crawford. Lifetime against this pitcher. Not a big sample size, 0-1. He's ready. Here's the first pitch. In his career, Crawford hits in the 240s, so there's room for improvement in that regard.
You know, Matty, I know his career batting average jumps off at the page, but this guy can help a roster in a lot of different ways. He brings value to the manager on a daily basis.
2-0 count, the pitch. hit back up the middle. And this is going to be through into center field for a base hit as the leadoff man's aboard in the eighth.
Nice execution right there, Dan. Kept his front shoulder in, kept his hands inside the baseball, and ripped the base hit up the middle.
And if you're a pitcher right there, you can't get discouraged. Sometimes even when you make a good pitch, the ball's going to find a hole somewhere. That one right up the middle.
And now, Donovan Solano. As he'll go after the first pitch and bounce it into foul territory. The Dodgers are looking for the sweep in this game, as we mentioned earlier, but trailing by one, they're going to need to come from behind to do it.
This one's still well in striking distance. Only trailing by one going late on to the game. They just need a bloop and a blast or some kind of extra base hit. This one's far from over.
Our pitcher's duel continues here. 2-1 score as we play the eighth. Heading out towards shallow right. There to look it in is Betts, and that's out number one.
The center fielder, number 13, Austin.
Next to bat for the Giants, Austin Slater. He flew out in his last debut. First offering. And, oh, looked inside, but that's ruled a strike. Nothing in one. Behind 0-2 now. Crawford, a runner at first with one gone in the inning. Tries the slider to ring him up, but he lays off 1-2. And a splitter swung on and missed that time, and that'll be out number two.
Well, his struggles continue. It's been a rough go of it at the plate with him, and watching this at bat, it's clear to me that his rhythm and timing, they're just all off. Even as a pitcher like I was, you can tell these things and exploit them.
So the next to bat will be Mike Yastrzemski. For his career in this matchup, he's 1-for-3. First pitch on its way. Fastball in there for a called strike.
You got to love guys auto taking you 0-0 if you're on the mound. You could steal that first strike, and now you go to work, just picking apart the corners.
On its way, the 0-1 pitch.
Man, that's a great take right there. Backdoor slider, just missed the outside corner. This guy must have a really good eye. Most guys swing at that pitch.
And he looks at one in there, 1-2.
Ooh, I'm shocked he got away with that one, boys. Curveball right down the middle of the plate. And for him to take that pitch looking, he had to be sitting on something else, but he should have pulled the trigger.
Here comes the 1-2. Freezes him, strikeout looking. Giants leave one as they're unable to add to their 2-1 lead. Jake McGee is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
San Francisco, number 17, Jake McGee.
Edwin Rios will pinch hit here, and he's the potential tying run. Now here's the first offering. And he's a guy looking to break out in a big way. Hasn't been getting the results he or his club have been hoping for. The 0-1 on its way. And he fouls this one off. The 0-2 pitch. good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning.
People always talk about how important getting the leadoff men on base is, and it's true. So in the eighth inning of a one-run game, that's a really nice job of attacking a hitter and sending him packing.
To the plate now, Mookie Betts. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. 0 for 2 from him so far in this one. Swing and a ball hit high in the air, deep down the left field line. This has plenty of carry. Dickerson is back to the track as he takes it for out number two. Digging in next, Justin Turner. His individual history against Jake McGee. He's got a batting average of .444. Here's the first pitch to him. Two out, nobody on. Swing and a miss. It's 0-2.
One pitch away from wrapping up a very good inning's work out of the bullpen here.
Takes a good swing, but this will be a foul ball. Still no balls and two strikes. The 0-2 once more. Misses for ball one.
This is a fun guy to watch when he's up there. Really battles. Doesn't take any pitches off. He's a grinder. Always seems to make it difficult on the opposing pitcher.
Nope. And he lays off it to even the count 2-2. And he comes back with one down and in for ball three.
Hey, this guy's a hard guy to put away. He's fouling off some tough pitches. 2-2 count, and he just seems to keep hanging right in there.
Fouled off. Another full count pitch home. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. And that'll get down out there for extra bases. And hold all tickets now as the tying run gets into scoring position with a two-out double. Finally, a little something for them to get excited about.
Yeah, a rally can begin with a single swing of the bat, and this might be their chance right here. They've struggled to produce a lot of runs, but there he is at second base. A shot to the outfield scores him. Then who knows what kind of roll they can get on. Got to take it one good at-bat at a time.
Here's Corey Seager. Not much in the way of productivity from him so far, but he's got a chance to come through here in a crucial spot.
Yeah, it's time now that he has to put the rest of those bats behind him, because none of that matters if he can clutch up when it really counts.
First pitch coming, here it is. Hard liner, but picked up on a hop. Oh, and it sailed right over his head at first. And he'll come in to score from second base, and that is a direct result, obviously, of that 4-4 throw.
Wow, I know shortstops have the reputation for being flashy, and I think he was trying to show off his cannon of an arm on that one. But the cannon was a little too powerful, and the ball sails way over the first baseman's head. He did get a lot behind the throw, though.
Cody Bellinger at the plate now.
And he puts it on the ground to second.
Reined in on the first. And this will remain a tie ball game as the inning is over. Only one in the inning here for the guys in blue. Ninth inning coming up. And we are tied 2-2. Jacob Amaya is going to go ahead and stay in the ballgame and play third now.
Now playing third base, number 52.
Blake Treinen will be on the mound to start the ninth inning, and his job will be keeping the ballgame tied until the bottom half. And that'll bring up the big bat of Alex Dickerson. He's had a great game so far, and a triple would complete the cycle. First delivery to him. Swing and a miss, and he's in trouble now, 0-2. As mentioned earlier in the broadcast, this game has the potential to result in a series sweep, but of course, with a tie game on our hands, that is no foregone conclusion.
Never easy to sweep. This is one of those teeter-totter games, back and forth, as we're tied going into the back end of this game right now. It'll be interesting to see how this one plays out.
The 1-2. Right side. Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway.
Up next to the Giants, the shortstop, Wilmer Flores.
Next, here is Wilmer Flores. He grounded out last time up. Set and the pitch. And they start him out with a slider. Good spot, but he doesn't get the call. 1-0. Now the Dodgers get a right-hander up and throwing in their bullpen. Swing and a hot shot toward third. A dive, but he can't make the play, and it's down the left field line. And he'll pull into second with one away.
Well, he was definitely struggling coming into this one, but I think we could say that cold streak is officially over. That's his second hit of the game, and it goes for extra bases. We'll see now if this game proves to be a huge turning point for him.
And time will be called here, as with the important go-ahead run at second base, they'll opt to go and get a little more speed out there. Standing in now, Kirk Casale, as he'll take a look at a slider here that misses for ball one. It could really use a knock here, 0 for 3 in the game so far. The 1-0.
This is going to be an interesting at bat. I think he has to be pitching for a strikeout here, so we'll see what kind of sequence he uses.
The 1-1 pitch.
Two balls, one strike.
In today's game, everybody's trying to work off the mound north-south, trying to elevate that heater. He wanted that pitch right there, but I can tell you as an offensive player, I'd rather give you 6 inches off east-west than to have you call that high fastball.
The 3-1 pitch.
Okay.
Go-ahead runs in scoring position here with one away. Struck him out. Struck him out again, I should say. His third punch out of the game.
Classic slider down and away for the strikeout there. Not a whole lot to say about that pitch that hasn't been said a million times already. That's just a real tough pitch for a hitter to pick up out of a pitcher's hand, so they end up chasing when they're in protect mode.
Tommy La Stella will be called upon here to hit with the game on the line. Here's the first pitch. And he's got that batting lineup near the 300 mark entering play. The 1-0. Swing and a miss on the sinker, a ball and a strike. Career against Blake Treinen. He's 2-for-4. The 1-1 pitch.
2-1.
Go-ahead runs in scoring position here with two down. Swing and a ball foul tip to the plate. And oh boy, that got the home plate umpire right in the arm too. Hit to first. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. So no runs on a hit here, no errors, one man left on. Dodgers with a chance to walk it off as we go to the last of the night. Matt Wisler enters to do the pitching, and best case scenario for him is to push this one into extra innings.
Matt.
Mauricio Dubon is into the ballgame as a defensive replacement. He'll be the new shortstop here.
Mauricio Dubon.
Now with the plate is A.J. Pollock. He was retired via the ground ball last time up.
The left fielder, A.J.
First offering on its way. Swung on and missed for strike number two.
Yeah, guys, he's got so much respect for this guy's fastball. You could tell he was out in front on that slider. I think he goes to the well one more time with that pitch.
Fouled away. Here he comes again, 1-2. Hit hard towards second. And there's one down now.
Oh, man, you can't hit a ball any harder than that. I mean, this ball gets on him in a heartbeat. Nice job to stay with it, though, and then make the out at first.
And that'll bring up the versatile Max Muncy. And now the first pitch.
He'll take that first pitch strike all day long. If they're going to take 0-0, he's going to pound that zone and get ahead. Much more susceptible down 0-1 than 1-0.
Now, pitch on the way.
One ball, one strike.
Bases are empty, one man out. And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1. Fastball is looked at for strike two.
He'll be fine coming out of the bullpen in this one if he can keep the ball around the knees like that.
The 2-2. And it's fouled away. One out, nobody on.
Yeah.
Got him! And he goes down on strikes for the third time. That was a nasty-looking slider that time.
Yeah, that was really well executed, Matt. A classic strikeout pitch. You think it's fastball middle in, then it starts bearing in on your back leg, and unless you hit it out front, there's nothing much you can do with that.
So now to the plate, Will Smith. And a swing from him yields a foul pop out of play to the right. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. Comes set, the 0-1. Off the plate and in, it's a ball and a strike. One ball and two strikes to count. Bases are empty here with two men out. And a swing and a miss there on a late breaking slider as he set down on strikes for the second time this afternoon. So they can't get that winning run home, and that means free baseball here this afternoon. Nine can't decide a winner. We'll move ahead to the 10th, and we are tied 2-2. Now we're going to have a conference at the home plate area, so it would appear that we'll see a double switch here. Corey Knebel takes the mound as he'll be the first man to pitch here in extra innings. All set for the start of the inning, and set to go is the veteran first baseman, Brandon Belt.
Number nine. Brandon.
Here's the first pitch. And he just misses inside with the fastball there.
This has to be a productive at-bat right here. I know you want to drive the run in and get the RBI, but you have to find a way, bare minimum, to move this runner over to third.
Belt in front, two balls and no strikes. And now some action in that Dodger bullpen as a left-hander has begun to get loose. Now the 2-0. Tried to crush that ball and now perhaps needs to shorten up with two strikes. Here's the 2-2 pitch. Now a fastball inside, and he works it back to a full count now. Tough curveball that time, but he's able to make a little contact to keep this at-bat going. And he misses ball four. So he comes out of the bullpen and immediately walks the first man he faces.
Just a nice piece of hitting right there, especially in extra innings. He didn't try to win the thing by himself or be a hero. He just patiently worked the at-bat until he earned the walk. We'll see if his teammates can pick him up now.
Brandon Crawford digging in next. His head-to-head numbers against Corey Knebel. He's hitless in three at-bats. Here's the first pitch. Sacrifice attempt here. One there. Well, he'll put this in his pocket and be content with just the one out.
That was kind of a high degree of difficulty play that time. You see the off-balance throw to second base, and he couldn't get a lot on it, but they did get the out.
Into the box now, Donovan Solano. As he will look at a first pitch fastball for ball one. And clearly this is a critical moment in this ball game. Go ahead run at third with one away. The 1-0. Laid off, but a called strike as that caught the outside. Runners are at the corners with one man out. Runners breaking for the plate. And a late squeeze attempt, and it looks like it's going to work. So they get the out at first, but the run will score on the suicide squeeze. So a gutsy call there, as that takes some serious stones to call the suicide squeeze this late in the game, but the go-ahead run comes in to score. Stepping in now, Austin Slater, as he'll take a look at a high strike that time. It's nothing and one. He could really use a knock here, 0 for 3 in the game so far. Didn't quite catch the zone there, ball one. Ball and two strikes now. Crawford stands at second with two gone. They try to come in with a fastball, but it's too far in, and it's even at 2-2. Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch. Now a fastball inside, and he works it back to a full count now. Payoff pitch on its way. Fastball too low, and that's ball four.
That was a great battle right there. He tried to get him to chase, but he laid off some really tough pitches and got a walk. Got to tip the cap to the batter that time.
Now at the plate, Mike Yastrzemski. His day at the plate hasn't amounted to much, 0 for 4, but this is a great opportunity to make amends.
Well, when your team really needs you, like they need it right here, you have to be able to put your personal struggles out of your mind. Right now is all that matters.
Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch.
Ooh, he's really in trouble, and it's just getting worse and worse and worse. This guy needs to find the strike zone in the worst way.
Here's the 1-0. Lifted the other way down the left field line. Pulled toward right center field. Betts finds some space out there for the catch to retire the side. So it winds up being a run on no hits, and they leave two men on. So now we'll see if these guys can get even in the bottom of inning number 10. It's the Giants 3 and the Dodgers 2. Tyler Rogers enters the game here an inning later than usual as he'll try to close this one out in the 10th. Now into the box, Gavin Lux. He has no prior history against this pitcher. First offering, and here's a fastball called for strike one. A one count, here's the pitch. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Dickerson's under it. And he hauls it in for the first out of the inning. And the runner, not tagging, will retreat to second base.
Now batting, catcher, Austin Barnes.
So here's Austin Barnes. No career at-bats for him against this particular arm in the past. Right, first pitch of the AB now.
Wanted to get the front door curveball on the inside corner there, but it backed up a little and stayed off the corner.
Runner at second here with one man out. And here's a fastball that's nowhere near the zone. It's 2-0 now. Now a swing and he gets him to pop it up. Will this be a big out of the bullpen? Solano will have plenty of room as he makes the catch, and there's a big out
now
number two.
Right fielder,
next up is Mookie Betts. He'll go to work on getting that tying run home from second. First pitch on the way. Here's a fastball upstairs, 1-0.
Okay.
One and one to the Dodgers leadoff man.
I always remember John Smoltz telling me the greatest asset a closer can have is short-term memory. And this situation calls for it right here.
Meanwhile, this ball gets down. It's a base hit. And he is out at the plate as the potential tying run. And that will be the electrifying conclusion to our ball game. Wow. A one-run game this afternoon, 3-2, the final finish. Matt Wislet gets the win in relief, his second of the year. Tyler Rogers earns the save out of the bullpen, his 24th on the season. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.
Afternoon. First for the victorious Giants, 3 runs on 7 hits, 2 errors, they left 7 men on base. For the Dodgers, 2 runs on 4 hits, no errors, they left 7 men on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 36 minutes. Our paid attendance this afternoon, a sellout, 56,000. The Dodgers thank you for attending today's game.